More people are dying from opioid overdoses in the Treasure Valley than ever before.
Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Don Nelson.
And I'm Michelle Edmonds. The coroner expects the overdose deaths in Ada County to top 100 by the end of the year. That's close to what they saw last year, but nearly twice as many overdose deaths as 2016.
The agency now investigating nearly a dozen deadly overdoses every month. Six on Your Side's Karen Lehrer has details in tonight's Finding Hope.
We had two over the weekend, and that's very common.
A significant increase in opioid-related overdose deaths in recent years is impacting the day-to-day operations of the Ada County Coroner's Office.
Our overdose deaths has skyrocketed, for lack of a better term, and specifically probably last 12 to 24 months.
Once a call comes into dispatch, the coroner's office heads directly to the scene of a suspected overdose, and an investigation immediately gets underway.
Determined that it could be drug-related, and so then that individual's transported by our office back to our office. And then that's where we'll complete toxicology and an autopsy.
Although the calls are coming in more often, handling the cases doesn't get easier.
Knocking on that door at 2 a.m. and telling individuals that their loved one has died and it's from an overdose, that's pretty tough. We've seen this firsthand destroy families and the emotional impact it has on not only, you know, the individual that finds our decedent, but then those generations.
Fatal overdoses are now happening so often, the coroner's office is no longer surprised to get the call.
My entire staff is to the point where, yeah, it's just we got another OD today, and that's pretty common. It's pretty typical.
Earlier this year, Coroner Dottie Owens thought just maybe the uptick in overdoses was coming to an end, but the optimism didn't last long.
I was hoping that we were starting to see a decline in these cases. March was a really low month. We only ended up with 4, but then we've averaged 10 to 12, depending on the month since March.
And if you think these overdoses are a result of IV street drugs, think again. Heroin only caused 4 of those overdose deaths so far this year in Ada County, a majority a result of prescription pills, often taken in combination with multiple medications.
We'll have an oxy or hydrocodone and then alcohol, or we'll have a methamphetamine, methadone, and an oxy. So a lot of the times we're seeing a combination instead of just a straight opioid.
Owens expects this year's overdose totals in the county to be similar to last year, around 100, most coming from Boise City, including hospital deaths within city limits, and most overdose victims share similarities.
40 to 50, 60-year-old men, that age range really seems to be where we need to target the education.
Owens says part of the opioid problem is a lack of readily available resources on addiction treatment options, something she hopes to help change.